If you're watching this, you probably like photography, and there's a good chance that you stumbled upon on the internet all those beautiful pictures and very sharp with macro when they catch the fly's head with all the thousand eyes looking at you and staring at you, very sharp and very colorful. Spider, flies, ants, and all these little creatures that are very scary looking from our side. However, if you are Ant-Man and you shrink enough, their world is starting to be actually very interesting. Macro world is basically looking at small things through a magnifying glass. Before we get into the macro world, I think it's important to understand the magnification factor. Basically, magnification factor is the ratio real size image versus what is projected on the sensor. For a 1x lens, a 1 centimeter object will be exactly 1 centimeter on your sensor. For a 35 millimeter sensor, that means you can see an object in full, it will occupy the entire image, a 35 millimeter object. Let's say an insect, which is 35 millimeter, which is quite big, will fill the entire frame. With the same rationale, a 2x magnifying factor means that the object is double on the sensor. A 5x magnification factor is basically 5 times bigger. You have an insect which is 1 centimeter large. If you use the 5x factor with the 35 millimeter sensor, you will not be able to see the entire insect, just parts of it. Let's consider an ant. The head of an ant, let's say 1 millimeter. In order to fill the picture on your sensor, you need to have a lens which is 35x, 35 times magnification to have a big, nice head in full detail filling the sensor. I own only one macro lens, which is the 100 millimeters f2.8 from Canon, because I'm a Canon user and I bought this for the wedding purposes. It has unfortunately a magnifying factor of 1x. Used as it is, cannot get bigger than 1:1. Fine. That means the wedding ring size, which is, let's say, depending on the finger, it will be about 2 centimeters. It will fill up a third of the photo, and that's about it. Doing my research on macro and this and that, probably the biggest magnifying factor lens I could see is the Canon MP 65 millimeters macro, which has the maximum magnification factor of 5x. So not even that lens is able to do an ant head to fill the picture. You need something 7 times more than that. And from that perspective, it's a little bit of disappointment, because it will go as big as 5 millimeters, and that's not what you see on the internet. You see a big head filling the entire picture looking at you. One interesting thing that I want to tell you about the macro lenses is this 100 millimeter macro lens has a focusing ring, and an automatic focus system will work on it. Now, the macro MP 65 does not have a focus ring, so the only way you can focus with that lens is actually moving physically towards the subject back and forth. The good news is I found and discovered a couple of hacks. Of course, I have not invented them, and there's ways around it. You don't have to spend the money, and you can use regular lenses in order to become macro and have a very impressive magnification factor. One thing you can do in order to bring the subject and magnifying it is to use an extender. Now, this is a combination of 3 individual extenders. You can go with this one, or you can add as many as you can. The more you add, the worse it's gonna get, and I'll explain you why in a second. Every time you have a lens and you move it away from the sensor, the magnification increases. As the tunnel gets bigger, the less light gets in, that means you lose exposure stops. So you need to compensate by increasing the ISO or having longer exposures. If you go crazy with this, after a while, the depth of field becomes so shallow, it's probably a fraction of a millimeter, is very difficult to focus. The problem with these, they don't work on any lens. They do not work with telephoto lens. They would work with wide lenses, and they do work with macro lenses themselves. The longer it gets, the less quality it has. So if you believe you're gonna get that sharpness you see on the internet, you're not gonna get it. Let's put magnification factor to the test. I've got the 6D Mark II, which is a full frame sensor. It has a 36 millimeter sensor, which is basically like a 35. And I have the Canon 100 millimeter macro f2.8. This has only a focusing ring and it will work on automatic focus. I do have a ruler here and also an SD card to give you a sense of the scale. This SD card is exactly 10 millimeters wide. 10 millimeters is 1 centimeter, almost a third of the inch. So let's see how close we can get. Exactly what we have here, it will be the same size on the sensor. 35 millimeters on the scale will be projected exactly on the sensor. Almost 35 millimeters in full frame. I'm just gonna take a shot. Now let's see what happens if we add this to the macro lens, an extension. So I'm gonna add 60 millimeters. Let's see what happens and how the magnification factor gets impacted. Looks like I'm able to capture 20 millimeters only. That means the magnification factor will be almost 2x. In this case, autofocus still works. I'm gonna add another two of these and see what happens. At this point in time, with three extension tubes, I have managed to increase the picture. The magnification factor, I'm counting here, a little bit less than 10 millimeters. We have managed to get here is 1 centimeter occupies the entire image. So 1 centimeter goes 35 millimeters. That means 3.5. That means I have achieved a 3.5x magnification factor without spending much money with this. Another thing you can do in order to get macro shots, you can actually reverse the lens. In order for that to happen, you need to buy yourself an adapter. This is a two-piece adapter. You can buy yourself a one-piece adapter, which is gonna worry only about the lens reverse. One of these with a cable, that means we have the option to put the contacts on the lens, which are away from the camera, and establish a connection with the camera. So what this means is actually you can do autofocus. The wider the lens, the better magnification it's gonna get. It doesn't really work with telephoto lenses, and I would suggest the wider the better. And another beautiful thing about this, you can attach an EFS lens, which does not fit normally on a full frame sensor camera, because I'm talking about Canon, and you can use the cheapest kit lens that you probably already have. For this exercise, I'm gonna use the 18-55mm EFS, which comes as a standard kit lens with any crop sensor Canon cameras. Okay, let's see what the magnification factor is with this thing. I can count 12 millimeter. So just by using this is almost 3.5. You do the math, I can see 12 millimeter with this. Let's say 13 millimeter. And remember, the most important thing is this makes autofocus work. The third and the last macro, let's call it hack for today, is use a combination between extension tubes and reverse lens. In theory, the camera should be able to talk to the lens through this adapter. However, autofocus will not work. I have achieved magnification factors somewhere between 7x and 10x. We are talking about getting the fly's eye in full frame to cover the entire picture. But the depth of field is so shallow, it's actually difficult to get something decent. You need to manually focus, and you need to stack your focus through manual methods in order to get something decent, and obviously fix everything in post-production. So ladies and gentlemen, this is as close as we can get with the maximum extension. Let's do a little bit of math here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 millimeters. So 5 millimeters will get the entire picture. So ladies and gentlemen, we are talking about exactly 5 millimeters. So what that means, we have achieved a 7x magnification factor, which beats the Canon MP65 macro. At this magnification factor, you have to be very still. You don't have to sneeze, you don't have to breathe. Everything will turn into blur in your picture. the wider the lens, the closer you're gonna get. The closer you're gonna get, the more shallow depth of field you're gonna have. If you get too close, your autofocus system won't work. Life is interesting between 5x and 40x. Think about the Ant-Man going into subatomic level. Life will not be interesting any longer. In macro photography, the biggest challenge is the shallow depth of field. Some of you already know that in order to overcome a depth of field problem, you can use something called step focus bracketing. That means you can focus in small incremental steps until you cover the closest and the furthest point you want in focus, and you combine them in a software after in post-production. In order to do focus bracketing technique, you can use an app on your smartphone or your tablet that will control the camera to actually take automatically those steps. And the bad news is it's not gonna work for macro. You can do that for landscape, you can do that for normal size where the camera cannot autofocus and you can set up the steps. But what I discovered, unfortunately, is for macro, you still need to use the manual movement between the camera and the subject. It is a very fine movement. You need to have a lot of patience. In the macro world, you need to reset your expectations about the quality and the sharpness. You're not gonna achieve the same sharpness that you can achieve with the prime portrait lens. If you end up spending a ridiculous amount of time with insects, that means something is very wrong with you.